Now, our profile guest, the reason why Cherry is here, is because this woman has a voice with a phenomenal range. It's been said to reach as low as an earthquake's rumble and as high as a parrot's shriek. This elastic voice made her a singing sensation during the 50s when she was adored for her campy, exotic act.
Now, rumors about her legendary past have always raged. She is a daughter of the sun, or is she a Brooklynite? Whatever her origins, a whole new generation has discovered her. Please welcome Peruvian vocalist Ima Sumac. I'm so excited. I like this little outfit, actually. I don't know how I got it.
Hello. Welcome.
Please sit down.
Ima, as we said in the introduction, you were a sensation at one time in the 50s, and then you sort of disappeared. You left America. Now you're making a comeback. Is that difficult for you to try and reestablish yourself? Because after all, we are people who by our very nature forget everybody instantly.
In my case, no.
Why not? Yeah.
Because many years ago, when I was performing the whole country, United States, I gave a tremendous concert, good concert, good quality the concert. And people remember Ima Sumac. So this time, when I come back, those people who saw Ima Sumac, and that time they have the children,
right,
very small, and today they are big boy, men. And the same people and the children came to see Ima Sumac after many years. And all of them, they told me, "Ms. Sumac, we are so happy to see you." And then some of them, they were crying. They made me cry also because it's so much. Yeah, I know your question. That's why I was asking myself, why? I asked them, to say, why you like Ms. Sumac, why? They say, well, Ms. Sumac, because we enjoy very much your music. That's the only thing that I can answer to you, my dear.
Now, you know, I read that you had no formal training, and yet you have a 5-octave range. Now, do you all know what that means? Is that correct?
I never studied with teacher.
Right.
My teacher was myself. I have a very good technique. Yes, I have 5 octaves.
Did you want to sing when you were a little girl?
Yes, when I was a little girl, yes. I was always, you know, I was born in the high mountains. In the mountains, you have a beautiful birds. You hear the dogs and the birds and the pigeons and the very strange sounds you hear also. So that was in my mind since a little girl. I never forget that. But I wanted to be a singer. My mother wants to be a great pianist. I say, no, I don't want to be a pianist. I want to be a singer. So it was no easy in the beginning to convince my mother that I want to be a singer because she didn't like show business.
Yeah. Well, you know, let's take a little bit of time to look at some of your past.
Right.
We have a film clip here which shows the kind of work that you did when you first came to Hollywood.
Yes.
Take a look. What do you think when you see that now? What do you think when you look at that question?
It brings me beautiful memories.
Yeah.
First, that I was very thin.
You're not spoken as a woman.
No, but I'm not fat. I'm not fat.
You're not.
You know, since I arrived to New York, something happened to my whole body because the weather, the climate, you know, something interfered in my whole system, really, really. And then even I got a terrible cold. I couldn't sing very well, but I did my best for the people. I explained to the audience that I had a cold, you know, which is very difficult to sing when you have a cold.
Yes.
But they say,
yes,
you, doesn't matter, we love you, Emma, you yes. do any sound.
Anything.
I say, I don't want to do any sound, I want to sing the right way, you know. But I did something nice for them.
Now, you had a tremendous publicity campaign when you first came to America, and there was all kinds of speculation about who you were. Some people said that you were a woman named Amy Camus from Brooklyn, which is your name spelled backwards.
Backwards.
And some people said that you were a princess from Peru.
Yes.
So how did you feel with all that speculation, and who are you really?
Well, they, no. I was born in Peru. I am Peruvian. I was born in Peru, and the man who wrote about Amy Camus, in the beginning, I didn't get mad, you know, no. But I think he made a mistake, or maybe he wanted to do some publicity for himself, but I didn't get mad, you know. And, by the way, I met the man a few years ago, and then he saw me, he ran away. But I say, don't scare, I don't want to do nothing to you, my dear friend. I said, no. I'm not going to sue, you know, but I
will. Yeah.
I don't want to damage anybody.
You sure you were born in America?
But,
you know when to sue.
Yeah. No. No. But then in 1955, I became American citizen. So I'm American citizen for a long time.
Yes.
So I love my country. I love the United States also. But I am real Peruvian, my dear.
Let me ask you something. In all the research that I read about you, I got the sense that it was not an easy road when you first started here in America, that you had your disappointments, a couple of movies that were not really hits, one that didn't even happen or materialize, the fact that someone spread rumors about your identity, and you finally gave it all up and you went back home. Why suddenly do you come back?
I was not disappointed, my dear.
No?
No. The reason that I disappeared from the United States after that I had tremendous success, I got a tremendous and delicious contract around the world.
Oh.
That was I was performing in Europe. And then I went to Soviet Union, all the socialist countries. I was working close to 7 years around. And then I became very tired. Because when you travel so much, you become boring,
yeah.
You know, and then I need rest. And my doctor told me that I need rest. So, and then when I finished all my engagements in Europe, I went to Spain because in Spain I have a beautiful home. So I stayed with my son for many months, and then I told him, from now I'm going to the Andes of Peru to rest at least 6 or 7 years. I don't want to know nothing about show business.
What did you
do
there?
I will explain.
Okay.
Explain. I didn't retire, no. The thing is that I didn't see my parents for a long time, so I was missing so much. My family, my father, my brother, my sister, my cousin, and my friend, because I'm the youngest in the family. And my family was missing too much. So I went to the mountains. We have a beautiful farms with all systems, I mean radio, shortwaves, everything. And there I started composing my music. Composing my music and resting, forget everything, show business. But I never said that I retired. So already I have 5,000 compositions, my own.
Wow.
So I don't worry anymore for music.
About music. No. Well, in tribute to this music, Nancy, I'll get it for you, Nancy.
You're going to pass these over?
Yeah. Do you want your red one?
No, I'll try something different.
Why don't you try pink?
Oh,
you're wearing pink.
Now, these are the kinds
I'll
of headdresses that you wore. Yes?
No, I never wore like that.
You didn't wear this?
This
has got to hurt.
What frightens me is that I like this.
Frightens me is that you like that.
This is a French, very French style, but it's beautiful.
Yes? Would you ever wear a headdress like this?
Oh, no, I can sing with that.
Do you know that this headdress and my body have the same shape profile? Have you ever in your life? Thank you. Emma, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
I wish you have the most beautiful baby.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. And great success. Great success.
Listen, don't leave us. We'll be back with a man who can make us look as sexy as soap stars after this.
So it was no easy in the beginning to convince my mother that I want to be a singer because she didn't like show business.
Yeah. Well, you know, let's take a little bit. Yes. Let's take a little bit of time to look at some of your past.
Right.
We have a film clip here, which shows the kind of work that you did when you first came to Hollywood.
Yes.
Take a look. Profile guest, the reason why Cherry is here is because this woman has a voice with a phenomenal range. It's been said to reach as low as an earthquake's rumble and as high as a parrot's shriek. This elastic voice made her a singing sensation during the 50s when she was adored for her campy, exotic act.
Now, rumors about her legendary past have always raged. She is a daughter of the sun, or is she a Brooklynite? Whatever her origins, a whole new generation has discovered her. Please welcome Peruvian vocalist Ima Sumac. I'm so excited. I like this little outfit, actually. I don't know how I got it.
Now, you know, I read that you had no formal training, and yet you have a 5-octave range. Now, do you all know what that means? Is that correct?
I never studied with teacher.
Right.
My teacher was myself. I have a very good technique. Yes, I have 5 octaves.
Did you want to sing when you were a little girl?
Yes, when I was a little girl, yes. I was always, you know, I was born in the high mountains. In the mountains, you have a beautiful birds. You hear the dogs and the birds and the pigeons and the very strange sounds you hear also. So that was in my mind since a little girl. I never forget that. But I wanted to be a singer. My mother wants to be a great pianist. I say, no, I don't want to be a pianist. I want to be Ima Sumac. So this time, when I come back, those people who saw Ima Sumac, and that time they have the children,
right.
Very small. And today they are big boy men. And the same people and the children came to see Ima Sumac after many years. And they told me, Ima Sumac, we are so happy to see you. And then some of them, they were crying. They made me cry also because it's so much. Yeah, I know your question. I was asking myself, why? I asked them, they said, why you like Ima Sumac? Why? They say, well, Ima Sumac, because we enjoy very much your music. That's the only thing that I can answer to you, my dear.
Hello. Welcome.
Please sit down.
Ima, as we said in the introduction, you were a sensation at one time in the 50s, and then you sort of disappeared, you left America. Now you're making a comeback. Is that difficult for you to try and reestablish yourself? Because after all, we are people who by our very nature forget everybody instantly.
In my case, no.
Why not? Yeah.
Because many years ago, when I was performing the whole country, United States, I gave a tremendous concert. Good concert, good quality concert. And then people remember.